Hello students, today's topic is pseudo force, and this is the topic in which so many students of class 11th have misconception about it. So today I will deal this pseudo force so that the student become to know what actually mean the pseudo force is. See here the pseudo force. So first of all, I am considering frame of reference, a ground or a highway. This highway or a ground will act as inertial frame of reference. This inertial frame of reference means right now it don't have any acceleration, having no acceleration. Then another working frame of reference, I am considering a trailer, a four-wheeler, and this trailer will act as non-inertial frame of reference, and it must have acceleration. Because of this, it will called as an non-inertial frame of reference because it not follow the Newton's first law. Now, what actually the acceleration it has? The acceleration of trailer with respect to the ground, T for trailer and G for ground, is equal to vector A naught. Now, the third body, I am considering a car. A car is there, and car having its own acceleration. And this acceleration is with respect to, first of all, trailer. And it is considered as vector A CT is equal to vector A. Then the car having its own acceleration also with respect to the ground. And it is considered as vector A CG. C for car and G for the ground. Now M. M equal to the mass of the car. And this car having the real force is acting on it. If real force is acting on it, then summation of all forces, that is vector F, is given as sum of all real forces acting on the body, that is the car itself. Now, the pseudo force, to know about it, first of all the inertial frame. What actually the inertial frame is? The inertial frame is the frame of reference in which Newton's first law is valid. Newton's first law is valid means the body remains unaccelerated if and only if the summation of all real forces is equal to zero. This is the inertial frame of reference. And because of that, the ground remains unaccelerated because all the forces acting on the ground itself is equal to zero. That's why here the ground or the highway road I am considering as a inertial frame. Now see here a one animation to see or to know about the acceleration of the two bodies. A working frame of reference, that is a trailer, and the body, second body is the car, having the relation of acceleration with respect to the trailer as well as with respect to the ground. See, both are having its own acceleration. Means that there must be what? A relative acceleration. Then what it will be? See. So first of all, we must have to know the non-inertial frame of reference, because the trailer will act here as non-inertial frame of reference. Then the non-inertial frame of reference means the frame of reference in which Newton's first law is not valid. Okay. Now, what actually the Newton's first law? So Newton says that the vector A or the acceleration of body will remains zero, that is the body will be in unacceleration position. If and only if all the real forces is equal to zero, then you can say that body remains at rest or the body remains in motion without changing its velocity. If there is no change in velocity, then definitely acceleration will be zero. Now see here again the animation so that to know more about the pseudo force. Here is the ground, a highway will act as an inertial frame. Second, the two bodies, a trailer, a working frame of reference as non-inertial frame. Second, a car itself will act as a particle. Now both having its own acceleration. Now what happened? See here, the acceleration of the car, that is acceleration of the car with respect to the trailer, vector ACT here, this with respect to the ground, that is vector A, that is acceleration of car with respect to the ground, minus of acceleration of the trailer with respect to the ground, that is the relative acceleration. Then the vector A, and vector A means nothing but the acceleration of car with respect to the trailer, which we have already considered in our first slide. Then it is given as vector A, or the acceleration of car with respect to the ground, see here, minus of vector A naught. This vector A naught is nothing but the acceleration of trailer with respect to the ground. Next, then what will happen? Multiply the small m, that is the mass of the car in both the side, in RHS as well as in LHS. Then we will get this relation, see here, okay. Then the mass into vector A is equal to F, see here, vector F, and this vector F is what? This vector F is the sum of all forces, and we know that by Newton's second law that vector F is equal to mass into acceleration. Because of that, I have replaced m into vector A of car with respect to g by vector F, okay, and this will be as it is. Then from here we can consider the acceleration of the particle or the acceleration of the car will be given as, see here, the vector F minus m into vector A naught divided by the m. This is the acceleration of the car itself, but we have to consider this equation to be too much important for us. Why is it so? See, a red circle is showing some correction term, that is minus m into vector A naught. This minus m into vector A naught is nothing but the pseudo force itself. Why is it so? Because the Newton's second law says that the vector A, that is the acceleration of the particle, is equal to the vector F divided by m. So that to follow the Newton's second law, we must have to add some another force, some another fictitious force or an imaginary force or an inertial force, and that force is nothing but the pseudo force, so that we should correct the given equation, this, so that it should follow the Newton's second law. And that correction term minus m into vector A naught is nothing but the pseudo force, because we are adding something as an imaginary force so that it should follow the Newton's second law at the time of non-inertial frame of reference, because in non-inertial frame of reference Newton's first law is not valid and we must have to follow the Newton's second law. That's why we have to add some another force, some extra force, and that force is pseudo force and nothing else. So students, it's all about pseudo force. Have a nice day.